welcome to part two of What's in My Hospital Bag. Today I'm going to be showing you guys what's in my recovery bag and my toiletry bag. If you guys have yet to see part one of this video, make sure to click the link down below as well as up in the cards. Or if you haven't seen my What's in My Baby's Hospital Bag video, that one will also be linked there as well. So at this point, it just feels like I should just make a What's in My Hospital Bag series because I've made so many of these videos. But I just really wanted to make sure that I showed you guys everything that I'm bringing and explained exactly why I brought each item. So today we're gonna be doing recovery and toiletry bag, like I said. So let's just jump right into it. For recovery, I'm bringing the same bag that I brought with Audrey. This is a Fila, I thought it was Adidas, a Fila gym bag, like a duffel bag that you bring to the gym. And I'm just gonna be hauling things out of here and telling you guys why I brought it. So as for this bag, it has two large side pockets as well as a big middle pocket. First side pocket is my husband's stuff. So I have some undies in here for him, some pajama pants, a pair of gym shorts, and two t-shirts. And I find that this is going to be more than enough for him, even if we do stay there a couple days, just because you wear an outfit there, and other than after he takes a shower, I just thought if he was wearing jeans or something, he might like some gym shorts, and then for nighttime, he has some PJ pants. And then I brought an extra shirt. I was only gonna bring the one shirt, but I thought, last time anyway, while I was in the hospital, I had some complications post-birth, and he ended up being almost the sole caretaker of Audrey for the first 12 hours of her life, even the first 24 hours, let's be honest. So if he gets spit up on, he has an extra shirt. Now let's turn this around. In this side is pretty boring too, some pads. Cause like I mentioned in my What's in My Hospital Bag part one, in the labor, my hospital does not provide very many pads or sanitary napkins. You get about three and they usually aren't refilled. To me, this was an essential because last time I definitely ran out and had to use my own. So I brought about three or four of those. And then I have some oversized, big granny, like Hanes underwear. I'm bringing these because at my hospital, yes, you do get the mesh underwear, but honestly, girls, if you've had a baby and you're a bigger person, tell me if it's a different story at your hospital. But to me, when I was delivering my daughter, I was a size large. I'm pretty much the same size now. But anyway, to me, that's not like the biggest of the spectrum. That's pretty, you know, average-ish, like on the bigger side of average. And those mesh underwear like cut into me. There was red marks, and that's the last thing you want after having such trauma to your body. You don't want more. You don't want freaking red marks and digging in. It was horrendous. So I'm gonna bring my own, because I could hardly imagine what it would be like for a, you know, someone even bigger than me trying to go in with these horrible mesh underwear. I don't understand. Like, they must come in various sizes because these are obviously like a size small. So, it was awful. So definitely brought my own underwear this time. Now let's get into the inside of the bag. In here, I tried to keep as minimal as possible for clothes and things I was going to be bringing for recovery. I just wanted to mention, as for nursing pads, nursing cream, anything like that, that is in my What's in My Baby's Hospital Bag. So that's in my son's bag. First thing I have here on top is a Belulu nursing slash car seat cover. This is like the Covered Goods ones, and they're amazingly soft, like crazily, crazily soft. This is like one of the softest things I've ever felt, but it's like half the price off of Amazon. I couldn't believe it. It's such good quality. Like, it feels amazing. And you can use it as a nursing cover or a car seat cover or a cart cover, like all these different things, just like the Covered Goods one, but it was like half the price. If you're thinking you'd like one of these, but you're not sure how much you'll use it, definitely recommend the Belulu Baby. I brought this in case I have visitors at the hospital, or like I mentioned in my previous video, I'm a very modest person. I get very uncomfortable, like just whipping parts of my body out for random people to see. Even the nurses and doctors, like I'm gonna be completely honest, unless I'm in excruciating pain and I've just passed the point of giving an F, I'm very, very uncomfortable with like my private parts being shown to people. So, especially if I have visitors, but also just if there's a lot of nurses coming in and out of our room, definitely gonna want a nursing cover of some sort. And then if I want to, I can also use this as a car seat cover. Although right now we have the car seat installed in the car and we have the, what I like to call the snowsuit cover. It's the JJ Cole Bundle Me, but it's not, doesn't have the like car seat insert itself because we're not allowed to use that according to our hospital and our car seat manufacturer. We're not allowed to use that insert, but it's just the one with the cover itself. It's like waterproof and it has like fuzzy on the inside. So that is currently on his car seat, so I'll probably end up just leaving that on. A nursing pajama set. This is from a Motherhood Maternity. I hauled this in like my early pregnancy and I'm finally going to be able to use it. I'm so excited. So it comes with a, this is from the Bump in the Night brand from Motherhood Maternity. And I got this on like extreme sale, so I don't know if they sell this specific set anymore. And if not, I apologize. But it just comes with some like very, very soft, comfy pajama pants. All of it's in gray, which I kind of wish I'd gotten like a navy blue or a black instead, but this was the only color that they had left in stock. So that's why I went with this. It comes with a little nursing cami, same material, has a little bit of satin around the neck. And then it also comes with like a, I wouldn't call this a robe. They called it a robe on the website. I wouldn't call this a robe. This is more like a fancy cardigan, you know? But anyway, because it's so short, but it has the satin trim and just a little wrap around the waist. It's so comfy and it's going to make me just feel a little bit more human if I do want to wear pajamas at the hospital. I'm going to be perfectly honest with you guys. I didn't change when I was at the hospital with my daughter until I was ready to leave. So I have no idea if I'll even end up wearing those at the hospital. I wore the hospital gown until I was ready to leave. I have no idea though. So I just have those just in case. Two different nursing bras. I have this one. They're both from Lamaze. This one is a nursing sleep bra in this light pink color. And this one's you can just whip open like that. So it's a sleep bra. It's supposed to be super, super comfy. So that'd be nice. And then I have this one, which is a bit more structured. It doesn't have underwire or anything, but it has the molded cups. And this one is in like this coral color, as you can see, duh. But this one is really comfy as well. But if it's, I decided to give myself more of like a put together option, I guess, where you can't see my nips and my boobs aren't down like to my waist. I thought I'd give myself a more put together option. And then I brought myself two going home outfit options-ish. Okay, I'll explain. So I brought two bottom options for going home and then I brought two top options as well. So first pair I brought, first bottom option I brought was these leggings. These are not maternity, but they fit me when I was about 6 months pregnant is when I had to put them up. So I really enjoyed these. These are from the brand Hyba. So this is like a workout brand, but I really love these and I love the stomach support that they give. They're just so comfy. And they have like this pretty detail on the bottom. So that's my first bottom option. And then I also brought a pair of Old Navy maternity leggings. So these are just like the basic ones. The reason I'm bringing myself options is because I was very, very grateful to have options with my daughter, Audrey. I found that I didn't really I brought outfits that I was like, oh yeah, this will work. And I didn't really understand how self-conscious I would be about my postpartum body. So I'll be definitely glad I brought options, I think, again this time too. If I get spit up on or something, I also have an option then. First going home top option, because I brought two going home tops as well to wear, has this like nursing cami. So this is just like a plain white nursing cami. And then this tunic top. This is from Planet Motherhood. Got it off of Zulily. So this is very, very flattering on the stomach. It definitely like flows away. So I feel like it'll be something that I won't be as self-conscious in leaving the hospital. It's very soft material. And then of course it comes down low so you can easily like whip things out to nurse. So I thought that would be a nice option. And then I put the tank top on underneath because that is way too low cut for my personal taste. And then I have a tank top. This is from the Gilligan and O'Malley brand. This is a bit of an older one. I bought this when I was very early pregnant with my daughter, like basically right before Target closed down here in Canada, which was so sad. Like, don't even talk to me about it. Like, I miss it on like a weekly basis. But there's a reason that reminds me why I miss Target. I've literally debated going to the States for a trip just to go to Target. Like I'm that torn up about it. So Anyway, moving on. I brought this. This is like black and gray with buttons in the front, and it's nursing. So this, and then I brought a cardigan to go with it. This is just a purple cardigan from this old store called Smart Set. They used to be part of Reitmans Canada. If you live inside Canada, it used to be part of Reitmans. And I used to work there in high school, and they closed down last year, I think. And it was so sad because I used to buy all my clothes there. Like even after I stopped working there, because I went from working there to working in a jewelry store, I think like halfway through high school. And yeah, I was very sad when they closed down. Anyway, so yeah, this is just a little like ribbed cardigan because it will be kind of cold when we leave the hospital. Like right now it's bouncing between +5 and -5 Celsius. It will be kind of cold still. So that is everything I'm keeping inside the recovery bag itself, except for my toiletries. This is my little toiletry bag. I'll probably end up putting this one down inside of this just so it's less to carry for my poor husband. This is a bag by Contents, the brand. I bought it from Target like 3 years ago, something like that. And it has like lots of pockets for toiletries. So I'll just quickly go through what I have in here. I have some makeup. I'm one of those people who likes bringing makeup. I brought makeup and I wore all of it. I wished I'd brought more with Audrey. So I just brought some like kind of basic stuff. Tip, if you're getting ready to pack your hospital bag, what I did was as things were starting to look as though they were running out, like my foundation, like my under eye corrector, as it was on the last couple of uses, I would just pop it in here and then go buy a new one then instead of waiting until it ran out. So that way I didn't have to go buy a brand new one to put in here, but like I wasn't wasting anything. I did that with my under eye brightener. This is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind. I wear this every single day, regardless. I've brought the CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous Foundation in 105. This is a really good one to just rub on with your hands and it gives you good coverage. I brought the L'Oreal True Match Mineral. Once again, did this with this. As you can tell, very little product left. Very little product left in there. And I brought an old e.l.f. Kabuki. I actually replaced this brush, so I got I put the old one in here for now instead of throwing it out. I brought this little thing that I got as a like sample from Clinique, and it comes with a blush and just two eyeshadows. I doubt I'll use the eyeshadows, but I'll probably use the blush in case I feel like I want to use the eyeshadows. Brought this little brush that came in like I think it came with a palette that I bought. So I popped that in there. And then I have two sample sizes of Benefit Give Me Brow for my brows, and then the Clinique High Impact Mascara. So that's all the makeup I'm bringing in this little bag. Now I have like my normal basic toiletries. So toothbrush, 2 for $1 at Dollar Tree, can't beat that. They're probably the crappiest toothbrushes ever, but they'll work for the day. I brought a little, this is a sauce container, but it has some prenatal vitamins. I don't know if you guys can see that. Some prenatal vitamins in there. I've brought 2 days worth. Toothpaste to go along with my toothbrushes. This is the 3D White from Crest. Got some floss picks. This I actually found at Dollar Tree and it was like the best find ever. It's like one of those old hairbrush mirrors. Were you one of the kids that had these from Claire's? Because I was. And I remember I went because I was like, oh, that'll be convenient for the hospital bag. And I went to Claire's. They've raised the prices on these things. Like one of these was like $13. I was like, no thank you. So I went to Dollar Tree and I found one there and I was like, that's much more my speed for a travel hairbrush. And it comes with a little mirror too. But I'm not going to show you guys because I don't want to blind you with the lights. But yeah, little travel hairbrush, some deodorant for me. Now let's get into the little pockets around the side. Sorry, there's a mirror there. The little pockets around the side. So let's go into my husband's pocket first. Just have two things for him. Body wash. This is both in the Dove Men Plus Care Clean and Comfort scent. This is our, I love the scent on him. So this is the body wash and shampoo, and this is the deodorant. So both in little travel sizes. Next pocket, I have the Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Lotion Plus. This is a travel size. Brought some travel makeup remover in case I'm wearing makeup and I just want it off my face. And I brought the St. Ives Fresh Skin Apricot Face Scrub. I brought some Q-tips and an elastic with some bobby pins. The reason that's not in my labor bag is 9 times out of 10 my hair is up anyway, so don't have to worry about it. I brought this little mini chapstick in case I lose the one that's in my labor bag and I just really need chapstick. I have that one. Then I have this like hair washing pocket for myself that includes some Batiste dry shampoo. Love that stuff. In case I don't feel like washing my hair, probably will though. And then I got, these are like cheapy. I haven't used this brand in years. I think I mentioned this when I hauled it because it was in a Dollar Tree haul. Probably at least since I was in middle school. And this is the Herbal Essences, and this is in Hello Hydration shampoo and conditioner. The last two things in here is I have, these two I mightn't use, but I thought I'd like to have them in case. So this is the Jergens Ultra Care body lotion. It's not like I'm gonna get out of the shower post-birth and like hydrate my body, because I don't have time to do that on a regular basis, let alone when I'm in pain from standing up. Like, no. But I'm just thinking more along the lines of if I have like a dry patch, because I do suffer from psoriasis. So if I do have like a dry red patch of skin, like I'd like to be able to moisturize that and not use up my Clinique stuff. And then this is the Marcel Stretch Mark Triple Action Cream, just to apply afterwards, because a lot of people have told me that they get even more stretch marks after the baby gets here. Which is like, I don't know how I could get more stretch marks. Like, it looks like my skin is stretched to the max. Like, I have a stretch mark like this wide, like at the base of my stomach. Like, I don't think my stomach can stretch anymore. Thank you. But just in case, thought I'd bring some of that. Yeah, that's everything in my toiletry bag. I hope you guys all really enjoyed seeing what was in my hospital bag, well, all of my variety of bags. I hope you guys enjoyed both part one and part two of what's in my hospital bag. Make sure to leave this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and leave a comment down below if you think I'm forgetting anything, because pregnancy brain is so real, and I could be forgetting like the most essential thing on this frickin' list, and please tell me. Please tell me if you think I'm forgetting something, because I probably have. So make sure to leave that down in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe for future videos, including ones with the new little baby who's gonna be here so soon. This is crazy, but make sure to subscribe for those future videos, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.